guys, it's Alicia, and today we're going over three easy ways to clear cached data. If you spend a lot of time online, you're probably familiar with the concept of cached data. You can cache data on a browser or a server. Storing that data makes it easier and faster to access. That means you can provide a better experience for your site's users. As an internet user, you can also load websites faster. In this video, we're going to go over the pros and cons of clearing cache data and how to actually do it. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, now let's ask the question, should you be clearing your cache data? If you're not experiencing any problems, you can let cache data expire on its own. On the other hand, there is no significant downside to clearing cache data besides that you'll need to reload everything from scratch. Take note, if you clear your browser's cache data, it can result in slightly longer loading times for specific websites. There's no need to clear cache data in most cases unless you run into an error. If there's a website that's not working as it should, or you're encountering an HTTP error when trying to access it, clearing your cache data is one of the steps that we often recommend for troubleshooting. If you're running a WordPress website, there are a few other reasons you might want to clear its cache. It can be a good idea to clear the cache whenever you make significant changes to your site, such as changing themes, adding plugins, deleting pages, or even uploading new products. Doing this can ensure that the new data can load properly. Depending on your web host or caching plugin, your website's cache might clear itself whenever you update your content. Clearing cache data works very differently depending on which side of the equation you're on. If you run a website, you'll need to clear cache data at the server level or through your CDN if you're using one. On the other hand, if you're an end user, you'll clear cache data through your browser. Let's explore each of those options. If you're using a PC or a laptop, you can read our complete guide to clear your browser cache, which we've linked below. Clearing the cache on mobile devices works a bit differently, however. When it comes to mobile devices, there are two types of cache data you can clear. The first is cached application data. These are files that applications save to your device's cache to improve loading times. Usually, you clear this type of data through your app management options. The second is website cache data. This is the information that websites save to your device via the browser cache. How you clear this data will depend on what mobile browser you're using. Clearing the browser cache on a mobile device is relatively simple. For example, if you're using the mobile version of Chrome, you can open the settings menu and jump to Privacy and Security, then Clear Browsing Data. Then select the Cached Images and Files option under the Advanced tab. This process will vary depending on what browser you're using. If you store cache data at the server level and you're using WordPress, there are a couple of ways you can go about clearing those files. Your web host may be caching data at the server level. In this case, you should be able to flush this data from your hosting control panel. That's precisely the case here at Kinsta. If you're a Kinsta user, you have access to the My Kinsta control panel. From there, you can navigate to Sites and select the website in question. Next, go to the Tools tab. Here, you'll see an option that reads Clear Cache under Site Cache. My Kinsta also enables you to modify cache expiration dates. To do this, select the Modify, then Change Cache Expiration option. By and large, if you set reasonable cache expiration dates, then you shouldn't need to clear it manually. By default, Kinsta clears your site's cache every hour, which should be frequent enough for most websites. To prevent issues with users loading outdated information, we also clear the cache every time you update a page or post in WordPress. If you're using a WordPress caching plugin, it should include an option to clear the cache manually. The exact steps will vary depending on the caching plugin you use, so we recommend checking its more official documentation for more information. CDNs work by caching your website or application's data in server clusters around the world. When visitors try to access your website, their requests are routed to the closest server. This serves up a cached version of your site or part of its data. In a nutshell, CDNs help you improve your site's performance by reducing its workload. A CDN's servers are usually optimized to handle massive traffic without bottlenecks. Plus, your site's data doesn't need to travel as far. It can be fetched from a nearby server that's part of the CDN. If you're using a CDN, it should include an option to clear your site's cache file from its servers. At Kinsta, we use the Cloudflare CDN for all our client websites. You can also clear the CDN cache through the My Kinsta control panel. To do so, select the Kinsta CDN tab and then open your site's settings. Inside, you'll find an option that reads Clear CDN Cache. If you're using an alternative CDN provider, you'll need to check its documentation for further instructions on clearing the cache. However, the option shouldn't be hard to find as it's something that you'll need to perform when using a CDN. Do you have any questions about data caching? Let us know in the comments section below. The faster your site, the better your conversions. At Kinsta, our entire infrastructure is built on Google Cloud Platform's premium tier network and compute-optimized C2 virtual machines, aka the best of what Google offers. This is just one way we're able to speed up your website by up to 200%. Learn more about Kinsta's features at kinsta.com/features. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.